Hello viewers, welcome to the another lecture of digital communication. This is totally conducted by Ganon, powered by Wishback. I am Professor Aritro De. In this segment, we are going to discuss delta modulation. Not any game, but it is a one kind of the modulation. In delta modulation, an input signal XT is delta modulated to another signal UT by two level, either plus delta or minus delta. Now this XT and UT is compared. If the difference is positive, that means more, then the signal is increased by one step delta. And if the difference is negative, that means less, then the signal is reduced by one step minus delta. The difference or error between the sampled value of XT and the last sample is given by ENTS, where N is the sample and TS is the sampling period, is equal to XNTS minus XCAPNTS, where XNTS is equal to sampled signal of ST and XCAPNTS is the last signal approximation of the staircase approximation. If UNTS is the present sampled approximation of the staircase output, then U of N minus 1 TS is equal to X cap NTS, which is the last sample approximation of staircase waveform. Now let us define a quantity B of NTS, which is equal to delta SDN ENTS. What is this SDN? SDN is basically signum function, which you have familiar earlier. So BNTS is equal to plus delta if XNTS is greater than equal to XCAPNTS and is equal to minus delta if XNTS is less than equal to XCAPNTS. Then BNTS is equal to plus delta if binary 1 is transmitted and minus delta if binary 0 is transmitted. Now let us discuss the delta modulation transmitter. Error signal is generated by the above summed block, the output of which is an error signal, is equal to E of NTS is equal to XNTS minus XCAPNTS. What is this TS? We have discussed earlier. TS is a sampling time. This output is quantized by 1-bit quantizer and delta modulated signal B of NTS is generated. UNTS is generated by the lower summer block and U of NTS is equal to U of N minus 1 TS plus B NTS. This UNTS is delayed by one delay circuit. What is the function of the delay circuit? Delay circuit basically delayed the input message signal. And XCAPNTS is generated. Now, let us discuss delta modulation receiver. Delta modulated signal is summed with original signal and then applied to a low pass filter. In this way, original message signal is retrieved back. What is the advantage of this delta modulation? Here, the signaling rate is low and the transmission channel bandwidth is also low. Also, the transmitter and the receiver of delta modulation is simple. Now let us discuss the problem or the disadvantage of the delta modulation. If the signal slope is high, then the sampled signal can't follow the message signal. So you cannot sample the signal properly, you can't form the delta modulated signal properly. This problem is known as slope overload distortion. And the reverse is also true. That means if the sampled signal slope is high, then the message signal can't follow the sampled signal. It is known as granular noise. Now, delta modulation application is in ECG waveform generation also in EEG waveform generation. So what we have discussed today? We have discussed delta modulation basic concept. Then we discussed generation of the delta modulation. Next, we discussed reception of the delta modulation. After that, we discussed advantage and the disadvantage of the delta modulation and the application of the delta modulation. So that's all for this delta modulation. Practice the delta modulation segment repeatedly. In our next segment, we are going to discuss some more advanced and interesting topic. That's all for this segment. Thank you, viewers. Bye.